Welcome to the Mount Pilgrim Missionary Baptist Church Network, where we are building faith and transforming lives, where our senior pastor is the Reverend James I. Perkins.
Well, good afternoon, and welcome to another Straight Talk here at Mount Pilgrim Missionary Baptist Church. And I'm sure I don't have to introduce myself, but to those of you that don't know me, I'm the Reverend James I. Perkins, and I'm the senior pastor here at Mount Pilgrim Missionary Baptist Church. And we do a series of interviews and talks with people that are doing some things. And what I call them is movers and shakers of Lenoir, Caldwell County. And these are the people that I want to interview. So without further ado, this is Straight Talk. And again, we welcome you to Straight Talk. And what it is, we just talk about the things that we are passionate about. We talk about the things that we love. And we are so proud to have so many volunteers and so many people that has a passion for Lenoir, that loves Lenoir, and are looking for Lenoir to be the greatest city, the greatest county, and the greatest community in the state of North Carolina. So those are the people that we're looking forward to interview. And I have probably one of the best known, and she tells me that she knows everybody and everybody knows her. And if you don't know her, after today, you will know her. So without further ado, I am just glad and I'm proud to have as our guest with us this morning, Miss Wanda Prince. Miss Wanda Prince. And Miss Prince is the co-chair of the board of directors of Pay It Forward Food Pantry.
Right.
And we're going to talk about the Pay It Forward Food Pantry at this time. So, Miss Prince, the name of the organization is catching. It really got me, and I thought, well, how unique, and how did you or they or whomever come up with the title Pay It Forward Food Pantry? I can understand the food pantry part, but Pay It Forward, explain to us where and how they come up with Pay It Forward.
Well, it is a mouthful. Back when it was started in 2005, a woman in the community named Carol Walker was instrumental and was as a member of Fairview Presbyterian Church, who sponsored it. They started, and that idea basically means we want to do something for you, but then in return you do something for somebody else.
Okay.
And that's just a belief we have, and I might say that a lot of our volunteers are people who are food recipients. And several years ago, we used to spend time with people that came there individually, I guess, before that all the federal regs got so strict. And I remember talking with people, and I might have a small group in that room, and some, and I said, well, how are things going? And this man said, well, I'm doing fine, and I'm working on my house, but I sure need somebody to come help me do so. Well, somebody across the room said, well, Lord, never laid eyes on them. So I'll come and help you.
Yeah.
So that's the whole idea. We do something for you, you do something for somebody else, and pay this forward.
Yeah. Well, Ms. Prince, that was good. And to add to that, that's what I believe that Caldwell County, Lenoir, is all about. Us helping each other and doing something for somebody else. And I think this is what has made us one of the most envious communities and counties in the state of North Carolina, because that all we need to do is just the word, just get out that somebody needs this, and somebody is going to facilitate, somebody is going to organize. So we just want to thank Pay It Forward Food Pantry, and to somebody that just spoke up and somebody took the initiative to say, hey, look, I know somebody can do this. I know somebody can do that. So we just want to say thank you. And you were talking about folks just doing things, and I'm sure this is probably mostly volunteers.
Oh.
And how has the word got out there to where I could come and volunteer, or, and Miss Prince, announcing the volunteer. What about donations? Or we can do that as the next time. But
okay.
What about your volunteers? How do you get volunteers?
Well, back some time ago, when it started, there were just volunteers, members of the church, and recipients. When I think I started somewhere along there, close to the time it started, and I remember that most of the volunteers were people who were receiving food, and wanted to do that, and then just members of the community. And although Fairview Presbyterian Church was sponsoring it, they were from all over the community.
Okay.
And we've had some people that have volunteered the whole time. So we pride ourselves on being an all-volunteer organization. But now, of course, you know, with something like that, it's hard to maintain that. And right now, we do need some volunteers. And in fact, I have a list of some of the things that need to be done because I think people that know about it don't realize how much goes on behind the scenes to get it done.
Right.
Let me just go ahead and say the Pay It Forward Food Pantry is open for food distribution on the second and fourth Thursdays of the month and the third Saturdays from 9 to 12. Well, that's only 3 half-days out of the month. And you think, well, that doesn't sound very like very much. But let me tell you all that goes behind the scenes. Okay, for example, we're associated with Second Harvest Food Bank of Western North Carolina, which is part of the major organization Feeding America that people might be familiar with.
Uh-huh.
And we have, of course, a lot of guidelines we have to meet to do that. So since that's the one we work with is based in Winston-Salem, food has to come from there.
Uh-huh.
All right. We have one of our volunteers who takes a big truck down once a month and gets a big order and brings that back, and that has to be unloaded and stored to certain standards for a big load. And then we also have food that comes in once a week from Second Harvest as well.
Mm-hmm.
For example, there are several organizations in the community that are food pantries, and a truck will come from Winston-Salem and they meet somewhere and these organizations go and pick it up. So that food has to be picked up and stored. That's one of the things that has to be done. And another thing that's a tremendous thing for us is that Food Line Groceries donates their perishable food. And those have to be picked up six days a week. Now, that's a lot. Now, what I'm talking about produce, I'm talking about meats, cheese, baked goods, that kind of stuff, things that don't last. And we get it, you know, when it's still good, but it's kind of, you know,
right
there. And it's just a tremendous amount of food. So that has to be picked up every day and brought in. And and then food has to be stored. We do have freezers and all that sort of thing. Another thing has to be done. All food that's brought in has to be weighed and recorded. I might a figure that I have in my head about how many pounds of food we received this month. I think it's 16,000. This month during the month of February we received 16,668 pounds of food. Now that's a lot of food, but now that's food from Second Harvest and from Food Line.
Uh-huh.
And of course we also get donations from various organizations. For example, when the post office used to have their drive in the spring, we were able to get those foods, and then there are churches and clubs and groups that might make donations, and we get, you know, donations like that, of canned goods and staples and so on. But then as far as other donations, churches and individuals and businesses have been very, very generous.
Mm-hmm.
We also get grants. Now, let me go back and name a couple more of these jobs, because if there's somebody out there listening, if they could just come in a half a day every now and then, and they wouldn't have to do it all the time, but help with this. Okay, for example, another big item we have is packing the individual and family food boxes for distribution. Okay, this food box that people get, weighs about 40 pounds. Mm. And it's got dairy, meat, cheese, eggs, canned goods, staples, yeah. produce. I mean, that's a lot of food. So an individual can pick up one box of food per month. So all these boxes have to be packed.
Yeah.
And that takes a lot of doing. And that's usually done on Wednesdays.
Yeah.
And yet, right in the morning, people would be there. And if there are people worried about COVID, this is an activity that would be safe because there's no contact with the public.
Right, yeah.
You're just back there behind the scenes working. And so, in a minute, I'm going to give you the person's name and phone number because yeah. I'm hoping people want to volunteer. And then, if you're computer skilled, we always need somebody who can enter client data into the computers because there's a system whereby once people sign up, they have a card. And it has a number on it, and anytime they come to the pantry after that, they just show this card, and that way they don't have to fill out any more paperwork. And that same card is used at various other food pantries throughout right. the community, so it's a very easy thing. And by the way, since I'm talking about getting registered, now, to register, you just provide name, address, telephone number, but a little basic information.
Yeah.
You don't have to have documentation. Now, the first time when you come, you know, if you've got your driver's license or something, it's got it all written out there, fine, but you don't have to have it. You just tell mm-hmm. us this simple information that we can keep because this is necessary for us to do to keep our inventory up there and also meet the second harvest requirements and so on to make it work. Mm-hmm. So I do want to say that to be able to get food there, it's very, very easy.
That's good.
And anybody in Caldwell County can do it. Okay. Anybody in Caldwell County. However, there are other places, for example, South Caldwell Christian Ministries in Granite Falls services that community, but we would certainly not turn anybody away right. who's yeah. a Caldwell County resident.
Yeah.
Now, there's another service we have besides people coming and picking up boxes. By the way, it's drive-through. It's drive-through. Now, before COVID came up, people came in to the building, sat in the entry area, took a number, and then they went by and picked it up. And as they picked up their groceries, then we had volunteers that carried that food box out to their car because a lot of our people are not too healthy.
Right, yeah.
Well, I found out later that one of those boxes was kind of heavy. So we do have volunteers that take them out. But once COVID started, back in, I guess, March last yeah. year, we started a drive-through service. So now
yeah.
it's drive-through. But besides those three distribution times, we also deliver food boxes to several places in the community. Some of them are Lenore Housing, Koinonia, Lenore High Apartments, Harper Avenue Apartments, and I think there's a couple more. And that's a big job. So those food boxes have to be packed, and then they are delivered to these locations mm-hmm. one time a month.
Yeah.
So people have to help with that. Sounds like a lot going on, huh?
Yeah. I heard you mention Fairview Presbyterian
right.
Church. What part does the church play, or was the church instrumental in getting this started, or is the pastor there, the CEO or the chairperson?
Well,
or how?
I'm not a member of that church. I'm a member of United Presbyterian Church.
Uh-huh.
But it was a mission of Fairview Presbyterian Church
yeah.
from 2005 to 2018.
Uh-huh.
And it was supported, of course, they did the same thing, you know, donations by individuals and churches and grants and so on. But just as I said, Carol Walker, who's the other co-chair of the board with me,
okay.
was very instrumental in that. And then I might mention Vernon Yunt right now is the director, and he's a member there, an elder. I don't remember who was the pastor then, to tell you the truth, but it started out in the basement of the church
yeah.
with a very small staff and very crowded. And I think when it started out, there might have been maybe 15 people that showed, 10 or 15 people showed up. Okay, now, the list, we're also required to keep a record of everybody that comes, is that the other. Now, back things have changed a little bit since COVID's going on, but we were serving 750, 800 people a month, which is a lot. Now, but I might say now, okay, for example, my February data is that we served 582 individuals during February. But I think there's the same thing is happening with all the other food pantries. There's several factors there. Maybe people are afraid to get out. They don't understand. It's a drive-through. A lot of people don't have transportation. And then people have been able to get more help through various services such as food stamps and supplements, this and that and the other. So there's not as great a need as there was. I know that sounds strange, but that's what's happening.
Yeah.
But our goal has been to reach 1,000 people a month to give food.
That brings up another interesting point where you're saying you're trying to reach 1,000. Do the same people come back each month, or should they stagger their month? Ike Perkins, I was there in February, and now I'm back in line again. Or how is that done, Ms. Prince?
Okay. People can come once a month.
4 minutes, okay.
People can come once a month. But we have the people, it's not the same people, but a lot of them are.
Okay.
But yes, there's a once a month that people can come there. But let me give you the name of the person to contact if people want to volunteer. A couple other things, helping operate the drive-through, cleaning the building, assisting with inventory, mowing grass. And of course, we always need prayer. But if people like to volunteer, they need to call Mac Reed Jr. And his number is 828-800-1170. And the address of the food pantry is 2058 Harper Avenue Northwest, right beside Gateway Nursing Center.
Okay.
On Harper Avenue.
Out here on 18.
2058 Harper Avenue. Now, you don't see it. It's a house behind some trees, but we've got signs.
Yeah.
But it's on the right, just past Gateway Nursing Center.
Okay. Could you just, in the amount of time we have, give us the operating time and the hours and the days, and maybe share with us again? We know where Fairview is at. And if I may, it's right across the street from the Boyne & Miss car wash. Is that where you...
I'm not sure the name of the car wash. It's right there at that corner.
There's a stoplight there.
Right, there's a stoplight.
Yeah.
There's a bunch of Habitat houses.
Yeah.
But you just go right on down Harper. See, because here's the church, and here's Gateway, and it's the next place. It's a bunch of trees, and it's got two driveways.
Okay.
Okay, the times are second and fourth Thursdays from 9 to 12, and the third Saturdays.
Third Saturday. What's the time on Saturday?
Same time, 9 to 12.
9 to 12. 9 Everything to 12. Is from 9 to 12.
Right, right.
Okay. That's very good. Well, listen, Ms. Prince, I had never heard about Pay It Forward Food Pantry until my son Douglas shared it with me. And this is indeed an eye-opener for me, to know that this kind of giving and love is available in Caldwell. And I hope that all of you that are viewing Straight Talk, that we will take advantage of the food pantry, but not just only of the food pantry, but take time out to volunteer for something that needs to be done there. So we don't always want to be a recipient of the goodness. We want to do something that will add to it. We want to be a part of it. So,
yes.
Ms. Prince, thank you so very much. And I can tell that your passion is there, because when you hear people talking, that's passion. That ain't taking over anything. That's love for it. That's passion. So thank you so very much for your time away and sharing with us on Straight Talk.
I want to say two more sentences. I want to thank the community for their support, and I ask everybody's prayers for our continued work.
Amen. Thank you. And thank you guys for tuning in to Straight Talk. And if it's any time that you would like to be a part of Straight Talk, just give me a call. My email is ikeperk@charter.net. My telephone number is 828-729-5892. And I can also be reached at Mount Pilgrim Missionary Baptist Church. So please, ma'am, and please, sir, if you feel a need or you desire, to be a part of Straight Talk. And if there is a need for a donation here, Miss Prince, here I go. If you want to plant a seed in this ministry, we do have a cash app. $ Mount Pilgrim, MountPilgrim, 539. Cash out, Mount Pilgrim 539. So thank you so very much. And I can't thank you enough, Miss Prince, for being here with us. And I hope that Straight Talk has been a benefit to you this week. May God bless you and have a good week.
Thank you for tuning in to another exciting segment of Straight Talk, where we get straight to the questions and answers that you would like to ask some of the leading people in Caldwell County. We look forward to bringing you podcasts that make an impact in our communities. So tune in every Thursday at 7 o'clock, where we will bring you Straight Talk. We want to keep you informed on activities that are going on within our communities. Be blessed. We will see you next week.